Welcome back to RPG Plus. We have ourselves a new crew member, so let's go talk to her, along with some of the other members, and see if there's anything new for us to go do before we go ahead to the next main mission.
Alright.
Looks like we have some time to talk to some people. There we go. More experience parts.
I prefer gold to silver, you know, for my metal. I figured you'd recommend me for one since I pulled your boots out of the fire.
If we present you with a medal, you'll end up sitting on stage listening to politicians make speeches for a couple of hours.
That's a good point. They'd probably make me shave, too. I spent the last 7 weeks working on this baby. No medal's worth that. So, Commander, why don't you tell me why you're really here?
I like to know my crew.
Yeah, we've done it before.
You, top of my class in flight school, I earned that. All those.
What are you talking?
Okay, put the Normandy in my hands, and I'll make her dance.
I have to go.
All right, see ya.
Some more experience right there. Almost missed it.
Yes, Commander.
Nothing new.
Carry on, Presley.
Yes, ma'am.
We had a few places to collect experience. Is there anything new back here to collect? Not looking like it. Anything new in my room? Nope. All right, Caden.
Commander, do you have a minute?
I always make time for my officers.
Off the record, I think there's something wrong here. This Saren is looking for records on some kind of galactic extinction, but we can't get backup from the Council? Sorry, Commander. There's writing on the wall here, but someone isn't reading it.
I hear
you. The Council doesn't want to believe anything's wrong. I'd call it human nature, but...
I hear you. It just seems like a group that's been around as long as the Council should see this coming. I mean, it's funny, we finally get out here and the final frontier was already settled, and the residents don't even seem impressed by the view. Or the dangers.
Alright.
Well, well. You're a romantic. Did you sign on for the dream, Alenko? Secure a man's future in space?
I read a lot of those books when I was a kid, where the hero goes to space to prove himself worthy of a woman he loves, or, you know, for justice.
What are you trying to say?
Maybe I was a romantic in the beginning, but I thought about it after brain camp. Biotic acclimation and temperance training. I'm not looking for the dream. I just want to do some good. See what's out here. Sorry if I got too informal. Protocol wasn't a big focus back in Bot.
Alright, tell me about it.
Tell me about it.
Biotic acclimation and temperance didn't last past the airlock. To the kids they hauled in, it was brain camp. Sorry, hauled in is unkind. We were encouraged to commit to an evaluation of our abilities so an understanding of biotics could be compiled. There are worse results of accidental exposure to element zero in the womb. Beats the brain tumors some kids grew up with.
Is there some question about how you were exposed?
My mother was downwind of a transport crash. It was before there were human biotics, a little after the discovery of the Martian ruins. It only gets iffy around 63 when Kinetics was running out of first-gen subjects. Until then, they'd relied on accidentals. A bunch of guys in suits show up at your door after school, and next thing you know, you're out on Jump Zero.
Jump Zero is Gagarin Station, right? What's it like?
Yeah, that's the official name. Biggest and farthest facility we had for decades. Right on the termination shock, the outer edge of the solar system. It's where they did all the goose chase FTL research before we caught on to using mass effect fields. It was a sterile research platform when I was there.
There were other kids in the same boat, right? At least you weren't alone out there.
That's true. We did have a little circle that'd get together every night before lights out. We didn't have much to do, though. It was a research platform then, and Kinetics kept Jump Zero off the extranet to prevent leaks.
Time to
then you must have had plenty of time to get to know each other.
Yeah, we'd sit around and bowl every night after dinner, play cards or network games. There was this girl named Rana, who had a little circle grow up around her. She was from Turkey. Her family was very rich. But she was smart and charming as hell. Beautiful, but not stuck up about it. Like you, I guess.
Sounds like she was special to you.
She was. Maybe she felt the same. But things never felt together. Training, you know.
You know of any intentional exposures for certain?
No one knows. Doesn't mean they didn't happen. As big as the exposures were, it was hard to track down accidentals. It was different then. No one knew the potential, so there wasn't a lot of regulation. Anything Kinetics did was gold. I'm not saying they intentionally detonated drives over our outposts, but in retrospect, they were damn quick on the scene.
Does sound a little suspicious.
Up Zero's a long way from home. What was it like?
The grand gateway to humanity looks a lot better in the vids. Anyway, this was supposed to be a casual debrief, not a bull session about stuff that happened years ago.
Yeah. I like to know who's with me, though.
We have to depend on each other in combat. I like knowing what kind of man I have at my back.
I understand, ma'am. I won't let you down. You, make a habit of getting this personal with everyone?
Well, it's pretty much say yeah.
Of course. But I don't enjoy it with everyone. We'll talk again later.
I'll need some time to process that, Commander. But, yeah, I'd like that.
Take those. Anything else up here?
Yes, Commander.
Doctor.
Is there something you need?
Look.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Commander, are you coming to check up on me?
You look much better. How are you feeling?
Dr. Chakwas assures me I am going to be fine. I was impressed with her knowledge of Asari physiology.
You're in good hands.
That's
Dr. Chakwas knows what she's doing.
I never properly thanked you for saving me from the Geth, Commander. If you hadn't shown up...
I'm just glad we got there in time.
So am I. I know you took a chance bringing me aboard this ship. I have seen the way your crew looks at me. They do not trust me.
I'll give them
but
time.
I am not like Benezia. I will do whatever I can to help you stop Saren. I promise.
Don't worry, Liara. I trust you. I know you won't let me down.
It means a lot to hear you say that, Commander. Thank you.
Let's get to
tell me about yourself, Liara.
Me? I am afraid I am not very interesting, Commander. I spend most of my time on remote digs, unearthing mundane items buried in long-forgotten Prothean ruins.
Sounds
dangerous. And lonely.
Sometimes I would run afoul of indigenous life forms or stumble across a small band of mercenaries or privateers, but I was always careful. Until the Geth followed me to Artemis Tau, I never found myself in any situation my biotics could not handle. As for the solitude, well, that is one aspect that most appealed to me. Sometimes I just need to get away from other people.
You don't like other people?
I suppose it comes from being a matriarch's daughter. People expected me to follow in Benezia's footsteps. They wanted me to become a leader of our people. Matriarchs guide their followers into the future. They seek the truth of what is yet to come. Maybe that's why I became so interested in the secrets of the past. It sounds so foolish when I say it out loud. It sounds like I became an archaeologist simply to spite Benezia.
Well, we obviously know she likes it.
All children rebel against their parents. It's a natural part of growing up.
You share the wisdom of the matriarch, Shepard. That is exactly what Benezia said when I told her of my decision. But there was more to it than that. I felt drawn to the past. The Protheans were these wondrous, mysterious figures. I wanted to know everything about them. That is why I find you so fascinating. You were marked by the beacon on Eden Prime. You were touched by working Prothean technology.
Sounds like you want to dissect me in a lab somewhere.
What? No! I did not mean to insinuate. I never meant to offend you, Shepard. I only meant that you would be an interesting specimen for an in-depth study. No, that's even worse.
Calm down.
Calm down, Liara. I was only joking.
Joking? Oh, by the goddess! How could I be so dense? You must think I am a complete and utter fool. Now you know why I prefer to spend my time in the field with data disks and computers. I always seem to say something embarrassing around other people. Please, just pretend this conversation never happened.
Oh, it's all good.
Do you know why Benezia joined up with Saren?
I don't understand it. She was always outspoken about the need for the Asari to become more involved in shaping galactic events. Maybe she thought allying herself with Saren would somehow be for the greater good in the long run. At least I hope so.
This hurts you, doesn't it?
None of this makes any sense to me. I have not spoken to Benezia in many years, but I know her. And this was not like her. Something changed.
I'd like to know more about the Asari.
We were the first species to discover the Citadel. We were instrumental in forming the Council, and we always strive to be the voice of peaceful cooperation in galactic disputes. My people believe we are all part of a single galactic community. Each species contributes something to the greater whole. Although we seek to understand other species, it seems few of them seek to understand us. The galaxy is filled with rumors and misinformation about my people.
Like what?
Most of the inaccuracies are centered around our mating rituals. My species is monogendered. Male and female have no real meaning for us. We still require a partner to reproduce. This second parent, however, may be of any species and any gender.
I don't understand. Your species can mate with anyone?
Mating is not quite the proper term. Not as you understand it. Physical contact may or may not be involved, but it is not an essential element of the union. The true connection is mental. Our physiology allows us to meld with other beings. We can touch the very depths of their minds. We explore the genetic memory of their species. We share the most basic elements of their individual and racial identities. We then pass these traits on to our daughters. It is how we learn to grow as a species, and how we develop a greater understanding of other races.
What happens to your partner after the union?
Every relationship is different. Some unions are a single encounter, with both parents parting ways afterwards. Others can be more long-term. Sometimes an Asari and her partner will stay together for many decades.
You know who Matriarch Benezia chose as her partner?
She rarely spoke of her partner. Though I know my father, if you want to use that term, was another Asari.
Benezia never told you her partner's name?
Union with our own kind is no longer common, not for the purposes of reproduction. Most Asari believe it weakens our species. Asari daughters inherit racial traits from the father species. If both parents are Asari, then nothing has been gained, or so conventional wisdom would hold. I am what is sometimes called a pureblood, though no Asari would ever be cruel enough to say the word to my face. It is a great insult among my people. It is possible Benezia's partner was embarrassed by their union. She may have been too ashamed to publicly acknowledge me as her offspring.
Can't just assume that.
Maybe she wanted to meet you but couldn't. Something could have happened to her. Maybe she passed away.
You might be right. I hope you are. But I have no way to know for sure. Benezia never spoke of her partner. Whatever happened, it caused her too much pain to dwell on it. She raised me by herself, though that is not uncommon. Many Asari raise their children alone, particularly if the father species is short-lived. Often the partner will pass on long before the child reaches maturity.
You Asari live for 1,000 years. What happens when your partner dies?
Few sapient species live as long as my kind. We have learned to take a philosophical approach to our unions. We do not focus on the inevitable loss of our partners. Instead, we enjoy the time we spend with them. And even after they're gone, a part of them lives on in us. The union is a connection that transcends both time and space.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
Alright. Learn some more about the Asari right there. Go down below and see what they have to say.
Why did you want to be a CSEC officer in the first place?
That's a good question. There were several reasons, I guess.
Like what?
Probably the same as most officers. I wanted to fight injustice, wanted to help people. I guess my father had something to do with it, too. He was CSEC, one of the best. I grew up hearing about his accomplishments or seeing his picture on the vids after a big arrest. He's taking my resignation pretty hard.
It's tough, but you'd think he'd be impressed you're going after Saren.
My father's a CSEC man to the bone. Do things right or don't do them at all, he says. He thinks I'm being too rash, too impatient. He's worried I'll become just like Saren. He actually talked me out of becoming a Spectre when I was younger, for the same reasons.
Damn.
You were asked to be a Spectre?
Well, I was targeted as a possible Spectre candidate, me and about 1,000 other Turian military recruits. I could have received special training, but my father didn't like it. He despises the Spectres. He hates the idea of someone having unlimited power with no accountability. He wouldn't like you, Commander. No offense.
Yeah, that's too bad.
Not all Spectres are like Saren, you know.
Of course not. But Saren's not gonna play by our rules, CSEC's rules. If you want to nail Saren, you need to send someone who isn't restricted by policies and procedures.
I agree.
You're a quick learner, Garrus. We'll beat him at his own game. It's the only way to stop someone like him.
I'm right behind you, Commander.
Let's just circle around here. Alright, Tom.
Oh, hello, Shepard.
Are you okay?
I don't know. Your ship is amazing, and your crew's been really great to me, especially your chief engineer. But I just sort of feel out of place.
Oh, you're one of
the
us.
The Normandy runs so smooth, it feels like we're not even moving. And the engines are so quiet. How do you sleep at night?
The silence wakes you up?
Back on the flotilla, the last thing you want to hear is silence. It means an engine's died or an air filter shut down. I guess you don't have to worry about that here. But old habits die hard. But it's more than just the silence. This ship feels so empty. It's like half the crew is missing. Back home, I couldn't wait to go on my pilgrimage. I couldn't wait to get away from the crowds. Now that I'm out here, I kind of miss them.
Yeah, it's bound to happen.
Sometimes we don't appreciate what we have till it's gone.
That's true. I'm starting to wonder if that's what the pilgrimage is really about. It's given me a whole new perspective on my people and our culture. You know, there's always a few who go on their pilgrimages and never return. I always assumed something bad happened to them, but maybe they just wanted a different life.
You do plan to return to the migrant fleet, right?
I could never abandon my people, Shepard. I will go back eventually. But we have to stop Saren first. Otherwise, I might not have a home to go back to.
I should go.
See you later.
Collected all that info. Courtyard.
Something I can do for you, Commander.
Carry on, Adams.
Aye, aye, Commander.
All right, Rex, do you have anything new to say?
What do you want, Shepard?
Why did you become a mercenary?
Lots of reasons.
Such as?
I needed to get out of our system.
I needed to eat.
I needed to survive.
Why not stay and help your people?
I tried to help. That's why I had to leave.
What happened?
I was betrayed. I was head of a small tribe. We were trying to restore order after the war, but the other tribes were against us. They followed Jared, one of the few warlords who survived the war with the Turians. But he was old, and so were his ideas. He wanted to continue the war. He wanted us to fight. Turians, Salarians, each other. It didn't matter who, as long as we were fighting.
What did you want?
I just wanted Jared to shut up. To stop his ranting. I wanted him to stop leading the tribes astray. But he couldn't understand how much things had changed. We didn't have the numbers to go to war. Even if we did, the genophage made sure we couldn't replenish our numbers fast enough. I told them all to forget about war. We needed to focus on breeding, at least for one generation. And for a while, we were getting through. Some of the tribes started coming around.
Some, but not Jared.
I take it the warlord didn't appreciate that.
No, he didn't. He arranged a crush with the tribes, a meeting on neutral ground. He wanted to talk. We met at the Hollows. Near the graves of our ancestors. The skulls of our dead laid bare to remind us where we come from and where we all go. It's as sacred as any Krogan place can be. Violence is forbidden.
Sounds like a trap to me. You must have suspected as much.
I did. But when your father invites you to a crush, well... There are some laws that even we hold sacred.
Jared was your father?
He was. Until that day. We talked. But we didn't get anywhere. When it was clear that I wouldn't join him, he gave the signal. His men leapt from the graves of our ancestors like Krogan undead. The few that were loyal to me died quickly. I escaped with my life, but not before I sank my dagger deep into my father's chest. That is why I left, and that's why I'll never go back.
Damn, wonder if that's how Rex ended up with that injury on his face. Alright.
You must have family other than your father. Don't you miss them?
No. Now that I have my family's armor again, there's nothing left for me.
All right.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Commander?
What's your opinion of the last mission?
Not sure I buy Dr. Tassoni's story about her and her mom not talking. They're family, right?
I think she's being straight with us. Or at least I don't think she lies very often.
Yeah, she's probably really bad at it. Hey, want me to ask her about her sex life? Might be illuminating.
Oh, come on.
Is that the best way to spend your time, Chief?
I read you, Commander. I'll behave. Too bad those ruins got destroyed. I mean, they lasted thousands of years. That's impressive.
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
Sure. I was hoping to get a minute of your time. Off the record.
I keep an open-door policy. If you have any concerns, lay them on me.
All right. I know things are different aboard the Normandy, but I'm concerned about the aliens, Vakarian and Rex. With all due respect, Commander, should they have full access to the ship?
Trying to say...
Don't mince words, Chief. What's your concern?
This is the most advanced ship in the Alliance Navy. I don't think we should give them free rein to poke around the vital systems. Engines, sensors, weapons...
You don't trust the Alliance's allies?
I'm not sure I'd call the Council races allies. We... humanity, I mean, have to learn to rely on ourselves.
Standing up for ourselves doesn't mean standing alone.
I don't think we should turn down allies. I just think we shouldn't bet everything on them staying allies. As noble as the Council members seem now, if their backs are against the wall, they'll abandon us.
I don't see that as inevitable.
Look, if you're fighting a bear, and the only way for you to survive is to sick your dog on it and run, you'll do it. As much as you love your dog, it isn't human. It's not racism, not really. Members of their species will always be more important to them than humans are.
These seem like deeply held beliefs, Williams. What made you think this way?
My family's defended the Alliance since it was founded. My father, grandfather, great-grandmother, they all picked up a rifle and swore the oath of service. I guess we just tend to think of Earth's interests as our own.
It doesn't sound like you've worked with aliens before.
No, ma'am. Mainly I've been groundside, part of the surface garrison forces. I did get a rotation on a space station for training. Every Marine a rifleman, every rifleman ZG certified.
That's odd. Your record is spotless and your technical scores are exemplary. You should be serving with the fleet.
Anyway, that's why I haven't served with many aliens, Commander.
You're lucky. I lost my family on Mindoir. Are you related to anyone I'd have heard of?
Couldn't say, Commander. I read about Mindoir. The Alliance screwed the pooch on that one. Should have had a bigger garrison. Is that why you're out here? To take the fight to the pirates?
No. The future of humanity is out here. There's so much we haven't seen yet.
Yeah. I still remember my first field exercise on Titan. When we hit mud, the reality hit me. I'm the first person who ever stood here. Then my drill instructor kicked me in the ass. I went face first into the muck. He spent the next 5 minutes chewing me out for gold breaking.
Don't tell me you had Gunny Ellison. He's the only one who uses that word to describe shirking duty.
Oh, Lord. You went to the Makapog boot camp, too? Yeah. Gunny Ellison's still reaming out recruits down there. Kicking ass and using words like inveigle and pusillanimous.
All right. I can see where your concerns are coming from, Williams. But this is a multilateral mission. You're gonna have to work with aliens, like it or not.
It won't be a problem, Commander. You say jump, I say how high. You tell me to kiss a Turian, I'll ask which cheek.
I'm glad there won't be a problem.
Anything else you need, Commander?
No, that's
dismissed,
it.
Dismissed, Chief.
Ma'am.
I don't understand the current concern when something she's just not used to. Not the one in charge here, though.
Mm-hmm.
We'll do Rex and Liara.
Equalizing interior pressure with exterior atmosphere. Logged. The commanding officer is ashore. Exo Presley has the deck.
What do we have going on here? Mihailovic?
Rear Admiral Mihailovic. Fifth Fleet.
All right. My bad. Back.
Commander Shepard, SSV Normandy.
You don't know who I am, do you, Commander? I command the 63rd Scout Flotilla. You and the Normandy were slated for my unit after shakedown. Then the Council got their paws, claws, tentacles, whatever. They got them on our ship and you.
I had orders.
Captain Anderson made it clear to me that my assignment came from way up in the brass. They say jump, I say how high.
Remember that when I tell you to jump. I don't begrudge the politician's decision to throw you to the Council. It's an opportunity. I do begrudge this over-designed piece of tin, though.
The Normandy is a fine ship, sir. She's served us well so far.
It's a gimmick, Commander. Useless in a stand-up fight. This experiment diverted billions from our appropriations bills. For the same price, we could have had a heavy cruiser. But no. We had to make nice to the Turians, throw money at a co-developed boondoggle. I'm here to make an inspection, Commander. Normandy is an Alliance warship. I intend to see she's up to snuff.
We'd be honored to show her to you, Admiral.
I'll just bet. Wait here. I won't be long. Commander, I'm not happy.
What are you on about?
What did you find out of order?
Who designed that CIC? Putting the commander aft of everyone else is inefficient. What if he needs to discuss with the operators toward the bow?
Everyone here knows how to do
things. There are no amateurs on this crew. They know to keep idle chatter minimized during combat. And I can bellow with the best DIs.
A fair point. I suppose the design has no chance of becoming standard. No need to worry about a generation of recruits learning things pass backwards. I had to shake my head at that drive core of yours, 120 billion credits of element zero to make this thing able to move without giving itself away. You realize we could make drive cores for 12,000 fighters with that money? What good is it to hide for a few hours anyway? Useless.
How do you get useless from that? Gosh. Let's explain why it's useful.
We can loiter in an enemy system and monitor traffic, or drop infiltration teams on enemy worlds. Normandy could be more effective than the Solarian STG.
Maybe. But that's not the job of a proper warship. We're supposed to find and kill the enemy fleet, not count how many times their garrison goes to the bathroom. And we need to talk about your crew, Commander. Krogan? Asari? Turians? What are you thinking, Commander? You can't allow alien nationals free access to Alliance equipment.
Okay, dude. I'm in charge
here. I'm Normandy's commanding officer. The regs state I have the authority to say who does and doesn't come aboard. If you disagree, send a complaint up the chain of command.
Sophistry, Commander. You know I'm right. You want them on board that bad? Fine. Don't quote regs at me. You have anything else to say, Commander? Any other justifications for the state of this vessel?
Not high enough for these ones.
None, sir.
Very well. I don't agree with any of this, but your reasons seem sound. I'll be submitting a report to the Joint Military Council. It will not be as negative as I'd planned. Good hunting, Commander Shepard. Make us proud.
You'd best watch it. Close to pissing me off. Ooh. Definitely have a few levels. Alright. Definitely have a lot to work with Liara. Get that. Get lift. Ionics. Definitely want that throw up there. Warp. Some defenses. All right. Looking good. All right. Got some new stuff on her. Never had anything new on that Baines person.
You are unlike the other Krogan I have met, Rex. You do not share the bloodlust of your people.
When you're young, you go looking for every fight you can. You get older, you realize the best fights will find you.
So saying though, never encountered that Baines person. I think it's probably something along with talking about the Cerberus, Black Ops. They're just using his name because they knew he was dead. Maybe not.
Commander Shepard,
knew it.
Sorry to bother you. This is Lieutenant Girard down in the docking bay. There is a woman here. She was rescued from Batarian slavers a few weeks ago. She is from Mindoir. I guess she was taken in the raid on your town.
Okay.
She's been a slave for the past 13 years. Is she all right?
Not really. She's a little messed up. She got free somehow, grabbed a gun from one of my guys. Now she's holed up here in the docking bay. She says she wants to die. I hoped you'd talk to her. It's a long shot, but you went through the same thing. The raid. I figured maybe you could talk her out of her tree.
All right.
I'm on my way, Lieutenant. Sit tight.
Anything you could do would be great. I don't want to. She's been through enough. I'll have my men stand by for you.
All right, let's go ahead and go back down.
Presidium technicians are struggling to understand why a computer system catastrophically overloaded recently. Technicians are reportedly unsure of what caused the malfunction, or even what the system was originally designed to do. CSEC is investigating the possible vandalism or misuse of public property.
How's that AI? Something from very early on.
Commander, glad to see you.
She's back there?
Yes, ma'am. Behind those shipping containers. I've got a sniper positioned, but I don't think we'll need him. She's only a danger to herself. We've got a sedative to calm her down, but we can't get close to her. Every step we take gets her more wound up.
You seem awfully worried about her.
I'm just doing my job, Commander.
One way or another, she's coming out of there.
Don't push her too hard. If she seems liable to pull the trigger, back off, or walk away. I am willing to wait her out. Good luck, Commander.
Strange. Stop! Stop! What are you?
My name is Shepard. Lieutenant Girard sent me to talk to you. What's your name?
Animals don't get names. The Masters put their symbols on her. Hot metal all over her back. She screams when they do it.
You must have a name. A name you were born with. Can you remember it?
She remembers a lot of things.
Talitha. They call her that. She doesn't remember the rest. Leave her alone.
What's the last thing you remember from Minduar?
Fires. Smells of smoke and burning meat. Animals screaming as the masters cage them. As they put the metal to their backs. Put the wires in their brains. She pretends to be dead. If she's dead, she can't work. But they know! She hopes they'll leave. But they put her in the pen. She didn't fight. She was already broken when they put the wires in.
Talitha, you were what, 6 years old? No one blames you for staying quiet and hoping they go away. The only person blaming you is you.
She wants to believe that. She wants to believe nothing would change. She doesn't want to be there anymore. In the pen, in the cages, lying quiet while they do things to her.
Damn.
How did you get here? Did you escape?
She can't escape. They have chains, wires, needles. You go too far, they take your brains away. Animals like her come. Animals with guns. They make the masters explode. She tries to fix the masters so they won't be mad at her.
Like her.
She puts all the reds and purples back in, but they don't move. The other animals take her.
The Marines who rescued you, they were the first humans you'd seen in 13 years. But you tried to heal your captors.
Oh, referring to herself.
Why?
If the animals can see her, then this is real. But it can't be. The wires, the chains, the hitting. This doesn't happen to her. It's another girl. A dirty girl. Stupid girl. She deserves it. It happens to her. Doesn't it? They see her, so it's real. She doesn't want it to be real.
What happened to your parents?
She sees them. They're yelling, run, hide! They hit the masters. But the masters, they have lights and hoses. Daddy's... he's melting! Shh! She doesn't want to see that! Don't make her look! Don't look! Stupid, stupid!
I don't want to hear that. You survived 13 years in a slave pen. You are strong enough to deal with a memory.
She's not strong. She's weak and stupid. All humans are. That's what the masters say. She sees them. Mommy and Daddy. Burning in white light. Melting. Going to pieces. They can't even say anything to her. They're dead, Shepard. They try to save her and the masters burn them. Can she stop remembering now, please?
I was on Minduar. My parents died in the raid.
Lying! You get hit for lying! Get the buzz or the burning. Can't be there. Why are you alive? Why are you? Why aren't you like her? Broken, only fit to dig and carry.
For a while I was broken. I lost my whole family, Talitha. My friends, my childhood. I had to pull myself up and keep going.
You lose your mommy and daddy, but you don't dig, you don't carry. You stand up. She wishes she could stand up.
I'm gonna take a step towards you now, okay?
No, she's no good! Don't want to be handled again!
I'm gonna take a step towards you now, okay?
She doesn't want... Don't touch her!
I'm gonna take a step towards you now, okay?
Please don't touch her! She's dirty. You'll catch it.
Tough one. I mean, take the chance to give her the sedative. I think in the end, she comes out doing it. Could make her stronger rather than forcing it on her.
Talitha, this will make you sleep. If you fall asleep, they'll take you to a place where you can get better.
Will she have bad dreams?
I'm not gonna lie to you. I just don't know.
She'd like that. It hurts when she... when I remember... me. But she wants to remember.
Alright.
Is it over, Commander?
She took the sedative. She wants to get better, Lieutenant.
Thanks, Commander. That means a lot. I didn't want to hurt her. It's just... when I see her curled into a ball and shivering... She was only 6 when they took her. Why the hell are we out here if we can't even keep one little girl safe?
To make people who do things pay. It's not the severity of punishment that deters crime. It's the certainty.
So we clean up the wreckage, shoot the guilty, and hope everyone else learns not to mess with us? Great.
Gotta do what you can.
I'll take care of it from here, Commander.
Is that it on that? Yeah. Alright. Let's go ahead and head on back. Some rough stuff. Can't imagine having to go through anything like that.
Admiral Kahoku, a respected member of the Alliance military, has passed away. The veteran soldier who won the love of his troops during conflict with the Batarians died of natural causes. Kahoku is survived by his wife and 3 children, who are planning a small private memorial service.
Seemed pretty natural. But I guess they don't want to come out and say, hey, it was due to some Alliance Black Ops that went rogue and doing all kinds of crazy research, stuff like that. We know the truth.
Commander Shepard? Khaleesi been seen in Al-Jilani, Westernland News. Would you answer a few questions for our viewers?
What do you want to know?
You've been given a unique position to represent our race. People want to get a sense of how you'll do that. Humans have been trying to get the respect of the galactic community for 26 years. With that in mind, what are your feelings on being the first human Spectre?
The Spectres represent the best of every species in the galaxy. To be asked to join them is an honor.
Some have said your appointment is the Citadel throwing humans a bone. Have you encountered any situations where the Citadel asked you to place its needs before the needs of Earth?
That's not like
the Council
that,
is
though.
Concerned with the needs of the whole galactic community. We're part of that community now. Our needs are on their agenda, but we're one of many.
You really do believe that, don't you? You've been given command of an advanced human warship for your missions. Is there anything you'd like to say about it?
Yeah, I'll say the Turians help. Working together.
Actually, the Normandy was co-developed by human and Turian engineers. Its design incorporates many innovations, all of which are classified, I'm afraid.
So the Turians have knowledge of the Normandy that is being kept secret from the Alliance public? Do you think it was appropriate to hand Earth's most advanced warship over to the Citadel?
I command it, though.
Miss Al-Jilani, I wear the Alliance uniform, and if you think anyone other than me says where the Normandy can go, you're sadly mistaken.
No offense intended, Commander. I'm sure you have to follow the orders of your superiors. Of course, now your superiors are aliens. One last question, Commander. Rumors back home say you're tracking a rogue specter named Saren. Do you have any comment on that?
You know what? I'll say he was behind Eden Prime. That way it'd become even more publicly known. Give him less places
Saren
to hide.
Saren instigated the attack on our colony at Eden Prime. Once his involvement was proven to the Council, I was assigned to bring him in.
That's surprising, Commander. The official line says Eden Prime was attacked by rogue synthetics. Good luck in your mission. Thank you for your time, Commander Shepard.
Alright, ourselves another level. Probably start getting health up. We're starting, or the heals up, because we're starting to get much higher health. Yeah. All right. Have anything else around here? Seconds investigating a woman named Helena Blake. There's no hard evidence against her, but if these reports are correct, she's a powerful criminal element on the Citadel. She was last seen near the Emporium on the Presidium. Okay.
I heard what happened under the Artemis Tau Cluster. The Council wasn't too happy about the destruction of those Prothean ruins.
This isn't a game, Ambassador. Shepard's out there trying to stop Saren from destroying the galaxy.
I know. Just try to be a little more careful. The Council's watching you, and we all get judged on how you behave.
Oh, gosh.
Yes, Commander?
Where can I find Admiral Kahoku?
Last I heard, he was up in the... Is there anything else, Commander?
I should go.
I'll be here if you need me.
I didn't give anything new. Alright, that's the person I found out about.
Got a moment, Spectre?
Fill in a blank.
Hello, Spectre. I have a business proposition for you.
How did you know I'm a Spectre?
Word travels. Your name comes up in certain circles. I'm acquainted with a pair of powerful crime bosses. They're hiding on remote worlds, and I have the coordinates. You could do the galaxy a favor.
What kind of defenses would these two have?
I haven't the faintest idea, but they're certain to be armed. Their partnership soured, and each believes that the other intends to kill him. They will be well prepared.
I eliminate them, and then you take over and try to eliminate me. How stupid do I look?
While I appreciate your estimation of my bravado, I have no intention of attempting to murder you. You are the first human Spectre, and you are doing important work for humanity. I have no interest in Red Sand or slavery. Anyone who does deserves to die. Our needs are aligned.
Okay.
You're obviously with them. Why don't I just arrest you instead?
Arrested for what? You and I are simply having a conversation. I have excellent legal representation. Arresting me would be a waste of your time.
Well,
what kind of defenses would these two have?
I haven't the faintest idea, but they're certain to be armed.
Okay, we've already been over
their
that.
Their partnership soured, and each believes that the other intends to kill him. They will be well prepared.
Yes, yes.
And what do you get out of this?
We share interests in certain cooperative ventures. But their business practices have forced me to terminate our relationship. Once they are dead, I will manage our organization in a more tasteful manner.
What crimes did these men commit?
They're red sand dealers who make victims of their customers. Those who can no longer pay are sold to Batarians as slaves. They're loathsome, hurting innocent people. They must be ended.
Do it. Not for you, though.
If they're as bad as you say they are, they need to be dealt with.
Excellent. Here are the coordinates. When these men are dead, I will wait for you at the third set of coordinates. Goodbye, Commander. It's been a pleasure to meet you.
Yeah, I can't say likewise.
Greetings, Earth Clan. I believe congratulations are in order, Commander Shepard. You are the first human to join the Spectres, yes?
It's a great honor.
One you are no doubt ready for. A word of warning, though. There are many eyes watching you now, Commander. Some of them want to see you fail. I, however, wish you only success. Perform well and you bring the Earth Clan one step closer to joining the Council. And if they let your people in, maybe there is hope for my own species one day, yes?
I should go.
All right.
Goodbye, Commander.
Going on here.
Who are you to tell me what my husband would want?
I'm the only person making sense right now. You're endangering your baby.
This baby is the only thing I have left of Jake.
All right.
I don't care what you think, Michael. It's my decision.
I know you're hurting, Rebecca, but don't let your grief hurt your baby too.
Can I help with anything?
Perhaps you can talk some sense into her.
I don't need anyone to talk sense into me, Michael. I'm not undergoing the treatments.
My sister-in-law here is pregnant, and she's refused to let the baby undergo gene therapy in utero.
I thought gene therapy was common.
My husband Jacob died from a rare heart condition several months ago.
There's a chance that the baby could develop the same heart condition, but routine gene therapy can eliminate it.
A very small chance, Michael. And extranet reports say the therapy could harm the child.
It's less dangerous than the genetic enhancements that every soldier in the Alliance receives.
What are the chances that your child will develop the heart condition?
According to the doctors, there's a 1 in 50 chance. And if my baby develops the condition, medical treatments are available.
Which are nowhere near as effective as simply getting the gene therapy.
What are the chances that gene therapy could hurt the baby?
1 in 300 at most.
But extranet articles say there could still be long-term complications we don't know about. Don't you understand? If my baby is that 1 in 300, I will always wonder if I killed my baby for nothing.
It's tough to give my input on this one. I mean, she is the mother. I think it's just right for her to be the one to choose. He's not even the father. So, let her
choose. It's Rebecca's child, Michael. I think you should honor her decision.
Damn it, she's not choosing! She's acting blindly out of grief!
And you need to support her.
Of course she is! So are you! Yelling at her will not bring your brother back!
How dare you! I'm trying to do what's best for the baby.
Then support the baby's mother. Stand with her when she makes the tough decisions.
This baby is the only thing my brother... It's all I have left of him. I need to know that the baby's safe.
It's all I have left too, Michael.
I just want Jacob's child to be safe. I want to give him that much.
We will. I promise. Thank you for talking with us. I appreciate it.
Well, hopefully, made the right decision. I mean, can you imagine the other way if, like, people did talk her into it and then there was long-term complications? She went through with it.
I hope he's okay.
Alright. What do we got going on here?
I'm on a break. Talk to someone else if you need anything. I've got a lot on my mind.
Maybe I can help.
Well, maybe you can. You're a soldier, right? You ever head out to the Traverse?
I'm not just some soldier. I'm a Spectre.
A Spectre? I heard they were thinking about letting humans into the ranks. About time. Well, that means you can go anywhere you want, right? Even out into the Traverse? Mm-hmm. My brother's the captain of a ship called the Majesty. It was crossing the Traverse a few days ago when it disappeared. Just dropped right off the grid. And that usually means one of two things. They had massive mechanical failure, or they were attacked.
Neither one of those options leaves a lot of hope.
I won't give up on my brother. Not yet. I've got the coordinates for the last transmission from his vessel.
What kind of ship was it?
Don't let the name fool you. The Majesty's just a small trading vessel, only a handful of crew. But he kept it in good condition. I don't think mechanical failure is too likely. But they don't have any real weapons or shields. If anyone did come after them, the Majesty'd be a sitting duck.
What's in this for me?
I can't afford to pay you anything. If I had that kind of cash, I'd have hired a recovery team to track him down already. Maybe you could look into this as a personal favor, you know? We humans have to stick together.
It's worth checking out.
Isn't anyone else looking into this?
My brother's just a small independent trader. Ships like his disappear in the Traverse all the time.
If your brother is still alive, I'll find him. Give me the coordinates.
I'll forward them to your ship right away. Please let me know as soon as you find him.
Anything else here? Emily Wong. Is that the one who I gave the data to? It is.
Hello again, Commander. I've got a proposition for you. Since you helped me get information on the crime syndicate, I've gotten a lot more backing from my publishers. I'm investigating traffic controller conditions now, and I wondered if you could help.
What do you want me to do?
I've heard rumors that the space traffic controllers are overworked to a dangerous degree. I can't get into the control room, but you could. If you planted a bug inside, I could crack the story.
If you crack this story, what's likely to happen?
Ideally, there will be calls to improve working conditions by hiring more controllers and upgrading systems. The Council won't pay for improvements voluntarily.
Right,
this story will provide that pressure.
What will this bug allow you to pick up?
Yeah, we were.
Just audio and video.
And
I'm
Rex's
not trying
head.
To tap into the traffic control system if that's what you're worried about. I just need to hear and see them in order to correlate their activity with traffic efficiency.
Everyone knows space traffic controllers are overworked. How is this news?
There's a difference between overworked and dangerous. Traffic at the Citadel has increased by 300% in the last century, but traffic controller resources haven't kept up. We already have several last-minute wave-offs per week. Do we have to wait for a full-blown disaster?
This bug you want me to plant, could it interfere with traffic signals?
Absolutely not. I made certain that the frequencies it uses won't interfere with anything.
I can't promise anything, but I'll see what I can do. Give me the bug.
All right.
Excellent. Just place it on a terminal with a good view of the area. Thanks again for your help. In the long run, this story is going to save lives.
Commander, I've been waiting for you to get back. I've got an idea, and I wanted to run it by you.
Oh, go ahead.
What's on your mind?
With so many human colonies being attacked, I'm not sure that one Spectre is enough. What if you signed me on as another Spectre?
Really?
Conrad, I haven't been shot in the head nearly enough times to make that seem like a good idea.
Joke if you want, but there were people who didn't believe in you, and you worked out, right? I know you're afraid to trust people after losing your team at a coup, but I'd never let you down.
Can't deal with this. I go with the test, not trust.
Alright, let's see. I'm a bad guy. Stop me from killing you.
What? No, please. Please don't hurt me. Why are you doing this?
Because you're not a soldier, Conrad. You can't handle this. Go home.
I thought you were a hero. Heroes don't do things like this. I wish I'd never met you.
I might be for the better. Alright, let's go plant that bug for the reporter. Conspicuous location. Can't even see it. Let's head on back door.
I'm already getting readings. This is gonna make a great story.
Thank
you so much for your help. Here, this is everything I've got from my publisher's budget.
It was no problem. Good luck with your story. It deserves to be heard.
I appreciate your support. I hope this will save some lives in the long run. Thanks again for your help. I'm gonna show this to my publisher.
Let's head on back to Normandy. Done all we can here for now.
Have increases in Citadel traffic endangered our safety? Emily Wong offers an inside look at the dangerous world of space traffic control.
Oh, shit, wasting time.
we have two other side missions to get worked on.
Stand by. Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
Alright, let's see what we have here. We have... go to the strenuous system. And hostile takeover. Oh, we'll start with this one. Go to strenuous system. Nebula cluster. Search for the ship. Strenuous, Foresight Nebula. Alright.
Message coming in. Patching it through.
Commander, Ms. Algelani's story on you just aired. She shouldn't have ambushed you like that. But you handled it the right way.
I hope so.
I've never had to deal with the press before.
You shouldn't have to. This won't happen again, Commander. We have a press corps, so personnel don't have to deal with her kind of BS. There is one other matter, however. The Citadel has been trying to play down Saren going rogue. It makes the Spectres look bad. Your mention of him was politically inconvenient.
How angry was the Council?
About what you'd expect. Don't worry too much about it, Commander. They're always angry with us. I won't keep you any longer. Fifth Fleet out.
Oh well. We have to look out for our own interests as well. Horsehead Nebula. Strenuous. Modular conveyor, human design, derelict, all compartments. Exposed to space. Fusion plant is leaking. Damage is consistent with ship mounted. Mass accelerator fire. Faint trail of radioactive particles. Possible exhaust from a sublight nuclear engine drive leads toward the nearby planet Azawan. Alright, so we are going to the planet. Just needed that first. My new go-to team. It's nice and all, but I want more controlling power. Oh. We have a lot going on here. Alright. We're just kind of moving a circle around. Spiral. Nope. Thresher Moss. Never had one stay out that long before. Tough. That it right there. Done. Thought so. Outside and want some. Head inside. What do we have?
Hostile spotted.
I will destroy.
Hold the line.
Go, go, go. I want to move me. All right. Well, let's go ahead and throw that one. Out.
I don't even need to hit that. Next. Alright, cleared.
Looks like we got him, Commander.
Get up here. All the way over there. Oh. Oh well. Just trying to spam the action button to climb. Discover the corpse of Captain Willem of the MSV Majesty. Stiff fingers are wrapped tightly around a small data pad. Let's see what the update on it is. Alright. Talk to Gareth. Turn to the Citadel. Tell him of his brother's fate. Located in the Han system of the Gemini Sigma cluster. Alright. Gemini Sigma Han. So it's like we're done here. It was easy enough. Deposit of beryllium. Check that out in a sec. Alright, scans of Paravan revealed an unmanned station in geosynchronous orbit. Your salvage team found no evidence on the origins of the station, but they did find one of Major Delnaga's writings on board. Alright. Just head on down. Thank you.
got going on here? Not much, especially compared to the last place. Syndicate hideout, debris. Let's head on over to the debris. Alright. So I've got something to deal with up top. Blind here.
Heads up!
Damn.
Watch out!
Didn't want to shoot. Come on. Sabotage my weapon? Warp right there. Charge. Behind. Come on. Peek out. There's someone else coming over here. Let's go ahead and meet this guy out here. Crime boss. Sniper.
Bring it on.
I will just
Helen was right. You guys had quite the operation going, but that's all going to change. One down, one more to go. I should heal it before using that.
Perimeter secured.
Go ahead and check in here. I'll finish sweeping the room when I come back out. I'm already on this side. Oop. back here. Anything out here, though? We'll even hit the other one. Where was this one supposed to be, though? Alright. No, not that one. In the disk system of Hades. Alright. Head right on over. The planet Raisha revealed an old unmanned shuttle. Your salvage team found Terran goods on board, all marked with the Triton colony insignia. Saw something right before coming in here. Alright, what do we have here? Deposit of lithium. Large deposit of titanium on a nearby moon. Head on over and get rid of these guys. This one has a little more. Then move around behind it real quick and get these out of the way. Mummified Solarian. Dead Traveler had a League of One medallion. Where he found it and what he was trying to do with it is unclear. They're shooting at us from right here. I mean, I wasn't ready to play yet, but I mean, if they want to. No one else. Hold on, I'm not quite ready to come over yet. There's nothing to do with this one. Weird. Bugged around the outside, maybe? I'm not seeing it. It's the first one like that. We'll get this debris.
Alright, now we're ready. See a spot to have mine nearby, so I'm gonna pick this up real quick. Platinum. Let's get rid of this group too. I'll handle the sniping, just stop.
Enemy is everywhere!
Oh, right there. Watch it, Liara. Yeah, you got it like right here.
I will destroy you.
Out. Got a level. What do we want to start putting points in now? Envelope Spectre. No, we still have some left. Boss. Helen or Blake will be overjoyed to learn that these two scum are no longer a problem.
He kind of just sat back and let all his men die. Was missing a ton of health. Might as well go ahead and fill it up since we're done with combat. In case we get any more medkits. Wait, am I able to open all these? Lots of loot here too in the back. Containment system. How does that look different? Not just not marked over it correctly. Oh, okay, guess we're not going this way. Supposed to be meeting her now. Right. Horsehead Nebula. The Fortunas. Horsehead Nebula Fortuna. Too. It all says chilly rock world. Valuable deposit of plutonium. Scanning the planet of Magandlis, you discovered the remains of a damaged research vessel. Your recon team found no signs of survivors. Did bring back a ROCOM outpost insignia. Okay. So far, it's not looking hostile. But she seems to be possibly keeping to her word. But head on in. Insane
save, just in case.
Hello again, Commander Shepard. I owe you a debt of gratitude. With my former partners dead, this syndicate is now mine. I could not have done it without you.
I killed them because they deserved it. Now I'm placing you under arrest.
Surely you don't think that necessary. Under my leadership, this organization will restrict itself to gambling and smuggling illegal technologies. These crimes are hardly worth your time. If you press the issue, my assistants are very well equipped to deal with you.
I'm giving you one chance to live through this. Shut this gang down.
What am I looking at?
I cannot believe you place such a high priority on stopping such petty, victimless crimes. If I disband the gang, I walk away freely. I have not come so far to be arrested. I would die before going to prison. I would most certainly kill before going to prison. Now, do we have a deal?
For now.
You're free to go. I don't ever want to see this gang again. If I do...
You won't. I'm not so foolish as to break my word to a Spectre. Now, if you'll excuse me, my men become nervous in the presence of law enforcement agents. Goodbye, Shepard.
Alright, I gave them a chance to back down, and they have. Now, what can I, confiscate? Say anything. Yeah, they don't even talk to me. Not much so far. Maybe they're keeping something upstairs. The other ones were keeping a bunch of stuff in the back room, so... We can definitely get in a room up here. I think we just gotta go back and tell dude in the Citadel Tower about his brother. Even she won't talk to me now. Just get to the tower instantly.
still take this elevator up after we get out. Alright, man, I found your brother. Bad news.
Any news? Did you find my brother yet?
We'll tell him he's dead.
I found your brother's body. His ship was attacked by privateers.
Willem's dead? I guess I should have expected this. When his ship dropped out of contact, I just knew. But I kept hoping he might still be alive.
I figured you'd want to know the truth, no matter how painful.
You're right. It's worse not knowing. That's what they all say, at least. Please excuse me. I need to go make arrangements for his funeral.
We did what we could. So we got a few of these done. Just need one more Prothean artifact. One more writing. Not too many more medals. We're getting there. Right, let's head back to our ship. Prepare for the next mission. Rewards.
Logged. The commanding officer is aboard. Exo Presley stands relieved.
Alright everyone, thank you for watching. We'll be ending it right here before we begin the next main story mission. See y'all later.